Ano ba ang PBB or performance-based bonus? How much ba ang matatanggap sa PBB? Saan ba kukunin ang PBB budget? Are casual and contractual employees included sa PBB? Welcome back to our video. Before I start, allow me to emphasize two important things. First, disclaimer, ang sagot sa tanong natin sa videong ito ay hindi personal opinion, but from www.officialgazette.gov.ph. Yan yung website ng Office of the President or Malacañang. So, facts ito, hindi personal opinion. Second, kung bago pa kayo sa channel ko, I suggest, please subscribe at my YouTube channel. Simply click the subscribe button below para updated kayo sa next video ko for employees. Thank you, friends, and God bless to you. Okay, let's get started. Unang tanong, ano ba ang PBB? So, may tatlong sagot tayo. Allow me to read the answer. First, PBB is a top-up bonus that is given to employees based on their performance and contributions to the accomplishment of their department's overall targets and commitments. PBB is a new incentive given to government employees based on their performance. This is different from existing bonuses in government. PBB was introduced by the Aquino administration to reward and encourage exemplary performance among public servants in national government. So, fellow government employees, so now we know na ang PBB pala was introduced by President Aquino. And ang PBB bonus or PBB is only for public servants in national government. And ang PBB, friends, is a new incentive pala ito, no? Given to government employees. Different ito sa mga usual bonus na tinatanggap natin. Bago ito. Aquino, si President Aquino yung nag-introduce nito. And thank you, President Aquino, for this PBB. Moving forward to our second question. How much ba ang matatanggap sa PBB? Answer, the amount will depend on the performance of each employee and the unit that he/she belongs to. Number one, the best performer from the best performing unit or best bureau will get 35,000. Number two, the better performer from the better bureau will get 13,500. And number three, the good performer from the good bureau will get 5,000. So friends, tatlo pala yung ibibigay na amount depende sa performance ng employee. So, kung outstanding performance kayo or best performance, you will receive 35,000. Kung better performance kayo or very satisfactory ang performance nyo, each employee will receive 13,500. And lastly, yung good performance lang will get 5,000. So, please take note to that. Mga ma'am and sir, fellow government employees, dapat pala butihan natin yung performance natin. Dapat outstanding performance para makareceive tayo ng mas malaking PBB. So best effort tayo sa performance natin, and kung better lang, 13.5 lang ang ma-receive. Kung good performance, 5,000 only. Okay? All right. So interesting yung topic natin, no? So let's move forward to our third question. Saan ba kukunin ang PBB budget? Answer. Number one, for national agencies, PBB shall be sourced from the Miscellaneous Personnel Benefits Fund or MPBF. Number two, for GOCCs, their PBB shall be sourced from their corporate funds. So friends, now we know kung saan kukunin yung PBB budget. So, yung mga national agencies like DepEd, kukunin pala yung PBB budget sa ano ninyo, sa MPBF, Miscellaneous Personal Benefits Funds. On the other hand, yung GOCC, like GSIS, to name a few, kukunin ang budget sa PBB sa corporate funds. Alright? So, moving forward to third question, are casual and contractual employees included sa PBB? So interesting ang question na ito. So ang answer, please allow me to read the content. Contractual and casual employees who have an employer-employee relationship with the respective departments, agencies, SUCs and GOCCs who have been in government service as of November 30, 2012 and who have rendered at least 4 months service during the year as of that date are eligible to receive the PBB under the PBIS. So very clear, kasali yung contractual and casual employees, basta merong employer-employee relationship. So moving forward to our last question. Kailan ba mabibigay ang PBB? Answer, the PBB will be given to employees only after their departments and agencies have, number one, accomplish all PBIS eligibility criteria. Number two, met their performance targets. And number three, submitted all their accomplishment reports to the AO25 task force before the deadline. The final deadline for such accomplishment reports will be in the first week of January. However, agencies that have met their performance targets by November 30 may have their actual performance evaluated sooner so that the government can facilitate the possible release of the PBB within December. So, fellow government employees, meron tayong timeline. So, i-observe lang yan ng agency natin. Then, i-submit yung report, performance targets, and sa 8 to 5 is i-accomplish lang yung requirement na tatlo, and you will get or receive your PBB. Okay? So, sir and ma'am, hope you like our video content. So if you like our video, please hit the thumbs up button, write a comment in our comment section, and please subscribe at my YouTube channel. Next week again, see you, keep safe and healthy, God bless, and 2 thumbs up.